Hello, I'm Atuba George. Now, we've been talking about the things that pertain to life. Praise God. 2 Peter 1 verse 3, he says, according as his divine power had given unto us all things. Each time I read this thing, it hits my spirit. See, now when he says all things, he means all things. I don't know what you want to. There is nothing that is excluded from these all things. See, according as his divine power. In other words, God put everything of himself into seeing to it that all things that pertains to your life and you functioning godly has been given to you. So why are we not experiencing or functioning in this? See, listen. Number one, you need to get that it is an ability that was given to you. Now, when he says, according as his divine power has given us all things that pertain to life and God, he's not saying God will throw a car at you, God will throw a house at you, God will throw all these things at you. So you see that, say, where are the things? And then you are looking at, where is the house? Where is the money? Where is the... No! It is ability that he has given to you. Now, your job is to learn how to carry out this function or how to put to work this ability that you have. What has God given to you? He's giving to you the ability to receive all the money you need in this life. He's giving you ability to receive all the houses, landed properties for whatever you need in this life. He's giving you the ability. Oh, I pray. You see, that's why he says, through the knowledge of him. You need to understand this. Now, the more you know him, you know what's going to happen to you? The more you are realizing your ability. See, he says, Hebrews tells us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Do you know what that means? As I'm looking at Jesus, as I'm gazing at Jesus, how do you gaze at Jesus? It's not to build a cross and put in your house and be looking at it every day and be doing like this, you know. No, that's not how you gaze at Jesus. You look at him by the Holy Spirit, praise God. How do you look at Jesus? You depend on the Holy Spirit to tell you what you should do on a daily basis in every situation, every decision you want to make. You go before the Lord and say, Lord, I'm thinking of taking this decision. What do you have to say concerning it? Now, when he tells you, you don't just do it like, okay, that's what the Lord says I should do. You begin to ponder on it and think about it. Remember what God told Joshua, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate therein day and night, so that you will always observe to do according to all that is written therein, and then you shall make your way prosperous, and then you shall have good success. How does that work? The Holy Spirit tells you something. You know, for example, the Holy Spirit tells you, I want you to do so, go visit so-and-so person. And then you just, okay, the Holy Spirit says I should go and visit. Then you go there, the Holy Spirit says I should come and visit you. So I'm here. So how are you? Fine. Okay, I fulfilled what the Lord told me to do. I'm going back. No, you begin to ponder on it. Why did the Holy Spirit tell me to go see that person? You mean this person is so important enough that the Holy Spirit will tell me in my house to go see that person? Now, while you're pondering on all those thoughts, do you know what you're doing? You are seeking the knowledge of Jesus Christ. You are seeking the knowledge of God. You say, how? Yeah, because as you're pondering on it, you're giving the... You know, I told you last week, I said, ask the right question and ask the right person. See, the right person to ask your questions is the Holy Spirit. Now, when he gives you answers, he increases your knowledge of Jesus Christ. See, you may ask the Holy Spirit about a car. By the time he gives you an answer, he's going to increase your knowledge of Jesus, because he's going to let you know why Jesus wants you to have that car. So you realize, you mean Jesus thinks about cars too? That's how the Holy Spirit is. So anytime he talks to you, he's increasing your knowledge. Now, as he's increasing your knowledge, what's going to happen to you? He's increasing your ability. You see, it's the Holy Spirit. Maybe you're a poor person. You've never received an amount of money before. But you want to grow to that point. You see, you can be there, all you have is maybe money for food or stuff. But then you want to increase. You, Lord, I want to increase. I just want to increase. Now, how does he increase you? He doesn't increase you by... All of a sudden, you see money in your bank account. And then that doesn't mean you've increased. You can become broke again. See? But how does he increase you? He begins to increase your knowledge of Jesus Christ. That's the first place the transformation comes. In your heart, your mind begins to expand. He says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. See, you can be conformed to being broke. I'm telling you the truth. You can be conformed to being broke. And then you begin to give the excuse, you know, I'm okay. Oh, see those people that have money. Do you know the problems they have? You are conforming to being broke and poor. See? But you see, you can depend on him to enlarge your ability. See, because actually it has been given to you. Now, as your ability begins to expand, how does he expand? He is teaching you the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. You know, I was watching a video recently, you know, and a dear woman of God was preaching. And I was watching with my wife, and I said something to my wife. I said, you see something? You see how everyone is excited at this message? But can I tell you something that will shock you? She said, what? I said, what I see here is, I see a woman who didn't spend time before the Lord before coming to preach this message. Rather, I see a woman who's preaching this message from the place of office or house talk. You know how people talk around you, people there, you now take their words and go preach it. I said, how do you know that? I say, yeah, it's very simple. You see these things she's communicating? When you spend time with the Lord, this is not how you're going to communicate it. Now, you only know that when you spend time with the Lord. See, if you don't spend time with the Lord, you will never know that. The reason is this. You know, sometimes people think, marriages are failing in our church. Let's do something about it. So what are you going to do about it? Okay, let's start talking about marriage. So you go get books on marriage. I mean, husband, love your wife. Go even carry scriptures that deal with marriage. No, sir. That's not what's going to solve the problem. What is going to solve the problem is when your members begin to increase in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. When they increase in the knowledge of Jesus Christ, you know what's going to happen? They are increasing in their awareness of who they are. And who are they? They are God's. I've got to stop here. It's God. But we'll continue from here tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye.